Bacterial dysbiosis is a major contributor to my IBS, so stay tuned to hear about my antibacterial protocol. If you're new here, hi, I'm Amanda Malacheski, functional nutrition coach and digestive and allergy detective. For tips and tricks on how to manage IBS and other digestive and allergy challenges, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified when I post a new video every Monday. Hey everyone, it's good to be back with you on video. I've been away for a few weeks because I've been solo parenting while my husband is away traveling. But I'm back now, and today I'm going to talk about how I recently retested my gut and found that I again have some dysbiosis to manage some of my symptoms. So I'm going to share what I'm doing and why. And I'm already feeling a good bit better, even though I'm less than 30 days into my protocol. So let's get started. If you've been watching my videos for a little while, you're probably already familiar with the idea that bacterial problems in the gut can be contributors to IBS symptoms and other gut troubles like fatigue and diarrhea and constipation, brain fog, insomnia, even others. Despite all of my personal progress over the last many years, I have been having some increases in some of my gut symptoms, and I recently started working with a naturopath to do some deeper level looking into things because my symptoms continue despite me doing all the dietary work and the gut repair and everything. So she wanted me to do another stool test to see what was actually going on in my gut. And if you want to hear more about what I recommend for my clients with gut testing, you can check out my earlier video, Gut Microbiome Testing for IBS. So my test revealed that I had low levels of beneficial bacteria and elevated levels of non-beneficial bacteria. So we decided I was going to do a botanical antibacterial protocol. So the first important step to dealing with a bacterial problem is to make sure that your diet is aligned in a way that's not going to aggravate your symptoms. So I've talked a lot about this in several of my other videos, so I'm not going to talk about this today, but with IBS, this often means using a low FODMAP diet template or some other customized elimination diet. And if you'd like a little bit more information about this topic, you can check out my earlier video called Low FODMAP Diets for IBS, or also how to choose the right elimination diet. This is really important because if you continue to eat foods that are aggravating your gut, it's going to make it much harder for your gut to do the healing work that it needs to do. So the next step is to add in the antimicrobial agents. And what I'm currently using right now is a product from a company called Biobotanical Research called Biocidin, and their other product that goes with it called Olivirex, as well as some supplemental iodine, which my naturopath discovered I was severely deficient in, and it's also a little bit antimicrobial. So we also discovered in our testing that viruses seem to be part of my symptom picture, including Epstein-Barr virus and human herpes virus 6. And so the Olivirex product is also antiviral as well as antibacterial. And I'm also using some other antiviral nutrients in the protocol, including selenium, licorice, and L-lysine, which is an amino acid. I'm also always working with my protocols to correct any deficiencies that may be there. And so as a matter of course, to support my body's detox processes, I always am using a B-complex, and currently I'm using a liquid liposomal formula from Quicksilver, as well as magnesium glycinate. And my naturopath also has me on a daily iron and vitamin A supplement, which seems to have really been helping my skin. So while you're doing an antibacterial protocol, there is no more important time to do your basic digestive support practices. So this includes increasing your stomach acid, which helps make your gut an inhospitable environment for the bacteria that you're trying to get rid of, as well as using digestive enzymes with your meals to make sure that your food is digesting as well as possible. I also use a probiotic daily, currently the Megaspore probiotic, and I use this at bedtime after I've taken all of my antimicrobial herbs, so I'm not killing them as soon as I take them. So supplements are generally really customized, but if you'd like a little bit more information about the general recommendations I make for people with gut challenges, you can check out my earlier video, Supplements for Digestion and IBS. So sometimes these protocols can leave you feeling kind of yucky and nauseated and headachy and even a little flu-like. And what's happening there is when your microbiome takes a shift and somebody, a population of bacteria or parasites or yeasts or whoever is dying off, you can have some of these icky feeling symptoms. So what I use to help with that when that happens is either enemas, plain water enemas, or another product called GI Detox. And this is also from Biobotanical Research. And this supplement is a charcoal and clay capsule that helps absorb any of those toxins so they can't reabsorb into your bloodstream and they're eliminated when you go poop. And once I finish the current bottle of Biocidin and Olivirex, I've been suggested by my naturopath to move on to doing 2-week blocks alternating between garlic, and which is in the form of allicin. It's the active ingredient in garlic that's antibacterial, and oregano oil. So I'll do 2 weeks on the allicin, 2 weeks on the oregano oil, and I'll continue that protocol for another 2 months, I believe. So all of these things put together illustrate several important points that I want to highlight about managing bacterial or other gut infections with herbal and botanical solutions. So it takes a minimum of 60 to 90 days with these botanicals to actually succeed and make a difference with these critters, even though they are effective. They take longer to use than pharmaceutical agents. Secondly, it's a good idea to mix up the botanical agents and swap them out so the bacteria don't develop a resistance to the agents that you're using. And finally, it's always important to incorporate good self-care practices around diet and exercise and sleep and rest, as well as stress reduction as supportive practices to help make sure that your protocol is effective. Have you ever done an herbal antibacterial protocol? Tell me about it in the comments below. So I hope that this video today has helped you feel hopeful that there is something you can do to help yourself feel better despite any of your gut challenges. So if you could use some help figuring out the practical solutions that are right for you with your gut trouble or your allergy challenges, I encourage you to schedule yourself a free 30-minute assessment session with me, where I can help you sort some of the stuff out and we can talk about how we might help you get feeling better. And if you like this video, please let me know by liking it and forwarding it to your fellow digestively challenged friends or family. And please comment below if you have a question that you'd like me to answer in a future video. I'll see you guys next week.